Hello, I'm David.
Hello, I'm Natalie.
Hi, I'm Kevin.
Today, we look at what people do at the weekend. At MAP Advertising, Rachel Hansen is doing some market research for a magazine. It's a magazine for young men and women. Rachel wants to know what they do at the weekend.
Excuse me?
Yes?
Could I ask you some questions?
Of course. Sit down.
It's nice here.
Yes, it is. What do you want to know?
I work for an advertising agency, and I'm doing some research. It's for a new magazine, for people like you.
People like me? What do you mean?
People between 18 and 25 years old.
Oh, okay.
Right. What do you do at the weekend?
Well, on Fridays, my wife always goes to her exercise class. Then she visits friends.
Don't you go out?
Not on Fridays. I never go out on Fridays. I stay at home and watch television.
And on Saturdays?
On Saturdays, my wife and I always go sailing together.
Really?
We love it. We never miss it. And then, in the evening, we go out.
Where to?
Different places. We sometimes go and see friends. We sometimes go to the cinema or a restaurant. But we always go out on Saturday evenings.
I see. And now, Sunday. What happens on Sundays?
Nothing special. We often go for a walk. And I always cook a big Sunday lunch.
Oh? How often do you do the cooking?
Twice a week, three times a week.
Thank you very much. All I need now are your personal details, your name, job and so on. What's your surname?
Robinson.
But I never go out.
Cook the dinner.
I always cook the dinner. How often do you cook the dinner?
Wash the dishes.
How often do you wash the dishes? I always wash the dishes. I always cook the dinner. I always wash the dishes. We never go out.
How often do you eat in a restaurant?
I eat in a restaurant about twice a week.
At least once or twice a week.
Oh, we probably eat in a restaurant once a week.
How often do I eat in a restaurant? Once a month?
The Wheeler family live in the United States. Let's join them for a typical American weekend at home.
Our home here is fairly large. We have four bedrooms, an office, a bunch of bathrooms, I think four bathrooms. In England, you'd say it was three reception rooms, but it's a front room, a dining room, and a breakfast nook. We do a lot of things around the house on the weekend. We garden quite a bit, working in our garden. We play basketball on the basketball court we got out and back.
All right.
At the weekends here, I go out a lot with my friends on Friday or Saturday night. Sometimes we'll go to the movies or just go to other people's houses and watch videos.
Usually Saturday afternoon is crank up the barbecue. And
Tom, you ready for a hamburger?
That's our meal, because during the summer it gets pretty hot here, and sometimes you just want to be outside rather than be inside. In California, you really have two seasons from our entertainment point of view. Spring, summer, and fall are very much the same type of activities, and then winter is very different on the activities that we do on the weekend. Summertime activities are usually involved around the children's sports. My youngest son plays Little League. That's baseball.
You're going to see a lot of little boys taking a game very, very seriously. They are all dressed up in their uniforms. There will be quite a few teams because it's a large park area that they play in. And there are a lot of teams, a lot of different colored uniforms, and they're all playing their game.
Hello.
Hello. Kevin.
Hi.
Today we look at doing new things.
And making plans.
At MAP Advertising, Rita has some plans. What is she going to do?
Oh, hi, Julia.
Dreaming?
No. I'm thinking about evening classes.
Evening classes?
Yes. I'm going to go to evening classes.
Why?
Because I want to learn a foreign language. Japanese.
Why do you want to learn Japanese?
Because I like Japan. And I want to do something new.
Learning Japanese is going to be difficult.
I know. But I'm going to do it.
So, Rita has plans to learn Japanese. We join her now at her local college.
Right. How many languages do you speak? Apart from English, of course.
I speak Hindi.
Ah, how well do you speak it?
Very well. I can write it too.
Any other languages?
I can speak a little French. But I can't write it at all.
A little French. Can't write it. That's it?
Yes.
And you want to join our beginner's class in Japanese?
Yes, please.
Well, it's not going to be easy, you know. It's very different from English, Hindi, or French.
I know, but I want to do it.
How many languages do you speak?
I speak English. And I understand Italian and French, but I can't speak them fluently.
I speak two, Norwegian and English.
I can speak two other languages reasonably well, French and German. I also have some knowledge of Spanish and Italian.
Jean Abbott is a teacher in California. Josh Lafrano is one of his students. The course that Jean teaches is a practical one, automotive repair, or how to fix cars.
My program is a course in automotive repair. We teach people from the age of 16 through adults. We're located on a high school campus. It's vocational, which means that we train people specific skills that they could use in a job.
I like classes like this because it's more of the real world than it is sitting there reading a textbook, not knowing what you're going to be using it for.
Today's a work day, so when I go back into the shop, I have all of my students working on projects.
The students on this course spend most of their time in the workshop, where they learn practical skills. For example, today, Josh is learning how to replace a tire. First, he removes the wheel. And the tire from the rim. Then he's going to balance it. These students also have one lesson a week in the classroom which deals with the theory of car repairs. So, in total, they spend around 5 to 10 hours a week with Gene in groups of 18 to 20.
Every student is an individual that comes into my program. All of them think that they're going to be able to fix their own car. They all have that as a goal that they're going to get out of the program.
Hello.
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 Today, we look at planning a trip. At MAP Advertising, Tom Hall wants to go on a trip to Edinburgh, Scotland.
You wanted to see me?
Ah, yes. Come in, James.
And sit down.
Good meeting.
Yes, it was a very good meeting. Now then, these clients in Edinburgh, when's your next visit?
Let's see. Here we are. I'm going to see them the week after next.
I'd like to see them too, if that's okay with you.
Of course. I'm driving there on the Friday before. Would you like to come with me?
No. No, thank you. I won't go on Friday. I'll go on Sunday.
Fine. But why do you want to see these clients?
Excuse me. Tom Hall. Yes. I'll tell you later.
James Brady is driving to Edinburgh. But how will Tom Hall get there?
Rita, I want to fly to Edinburgh on Sunday the 19th. Can you get me a ticket?
Yes, Mr. Hall. Which flight?
The first. No. No, wait. I think I'll go by train.
By train?
Mm-hmm.
But the plane is faster.
Yes, but it's nicer by train. And the plane is more expensive than the train.
True.
And the hotel. Now, I know a good hotel in Edinburgh. It's called the Grand. Can you?
Tom, I know a better hotel.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right. Good. Thanks.
Rita, I'll talk to you later about the hotel.
How do you prefer traveling? By train? Or by plane?
I prefer traveling by plane because I get there faster.
I prefer traveling by plane because I like to feel like an astronaut and I'm up there always with a window seat to see what's out there.
Train if it's more convenient and I'm not in a great hurry. Obviously the plane is much more convenient if you're traveling long distances.
I prefer traveling by plane because it's faster, and in this country, it's much more accessible. The plane will take you where you want to go, and the train won't.
Sherry McGonigal works for American Airlines. She works at the ticket desk at San Jose Airport in California. So let's find out what happens at a ticket desk.
Passenger will step up and tell me which flight they intend to be taking that day, whether they have a ticket or not. If they've not got a ticket, I can issue the ticket right there at the ticket counter, reconfirm their itinerary for the round trip, check in their luggage for them, and make sure they're satisfied with their seat selection.
Hi. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Would you like to check that piece of baggage?
Yes, I would.
Okay, and your destination?
Ontario.
Ontario, Canada?
No.
Ontario, California?
Yes.
All right.
The three classes of service that we offer are coach class, which is the economy class, business class, which is better than coach class, and first class, which is the premium service and the best way to travel.
I have to say myself that first class and business is the only way to go transatlantically for such a long flight.
It's the only way to fly.
Okay, in Chicago, the flight number right now, flight 52, is gate K19.
Okay.
And you will be coming into the airport at gate number K6B, so it's only a matter of walking in the same terminal 13 gates.
Okay.
All right.
Super.
So just a one-way as of now. Did you want to return also to American Airlines?
Yes, Sunday travel would be fine.
Okay, thanks. In the morning, afternoon, or evening?
I prefer evening.
Prefer evening, okay. That would be our American flight nonstop service out of Vancouver Sunday night at 6:10 in the evening. And you'll arrive back here in San Jose at 8:30.
Perfect.
Each transaction is really different. There's never anything that's boring about the job. And that for the most part, the people that I come into contact with are really pleasant. And the people that I work with at the airport are really pleasant.
Hello.
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 Today, we look at people buying clothes. Clothes for women and clothes for men.
Julia Marsh and Rachel Hansen are shopping for clothes. Julia wants to buy a coat.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for a coat. Can I try this on?
Yes, of course.
It's too small. Here.
Yes, it is.
Do you have any others?
Yes. Over here. Try this on. It's your size. Yes, it is my size, but it isn't long enough.
Right.
I prefer longer coats. What about this one? This is your size, and it's longer than the black one. Would you like to try it on? No. I don't like the color.
Excuse me a moment, please.
Of course.
Do you like this, Julia?
No, I don't. I think it's awful.
Yes, you're right. Pity. It's the cheapest skirt in the shop.
What about this one?
That's better.
and this.
Oh, yes.
That's the best one. I'll try these two on. Oh, don't forget your top.
Thanks.
Now, where are the changing rooms?
Can I help you, sir?
Yes. I'd like the best suit in the shop.
What size do you take, sir?
Size 4.
How about this, sir?
Not bad. Ah, that's better. Can I try it on, please?
The changing rooms are over there, sir.
It's my size, but I don't like brown. Do you have it in other colours?
Yes, sir. We have it in blue, green, grey, orange, and yellow.
I like it. This is the best suit in the shop. I'll take it.
Yes, sir.
Now, back to Julia Marsh and Rachel Hansen.
Well, do you like it? It's a nice coat. And it's your size, but I don't like the colour. I prefer this brown one. Do you have that coat in my size?
Yes, I think so.
You were right, Rachel. I prefer this colour too.
But what?
It's the most expensive coat in the shop.
And it's also the best.
You're right. I'll take it. Thank you. Oh, what did you decide?
Well, the top was too long, but this skirt looked just right. I'm going to buy it.
Oh, good.
We're now going to meet Patsy Seddon. Patsy is the owner of a number of women's clothes shops. What exactly can you find in Patsy's shop?
The basic things like trousers and skirts and shirts and jumpers and jackets. And then you have all the accessories that go with it, like shoes, bags, gloves, hats, scarves, belts. Everything you might need to go with your outfit.
I mean, most of the hats this season are meant to come down low.
Every season has colour, which is its key to whether you're wearing the right thing this year or not. And colour is one of the most important points, really.
A cream or a black vest would go quite nicely with that. Just the black vest. Hold on, I'm just getting...
Actually, could I try on one of these jackets, please?
Yeah, which size?
12.
I'll definitely take that.
You'll take that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, it's nice. What's the price of it?
The jacket is £179 and the trousers, they're £115.
Clothes excite women and I don't think it happens with men quite the same, but it's certainly something that happens to women and they're desperate to wear it because they think they're going to look good in it. That's the key thing. It's got to look flattering and make them feel good and look good.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Today, we're going to look at driving. Now, do you know what this sign means?
You can't overtake. There's no overtaking allowed.
No overtaking.
That sign means that you are not allowed to overtake when you are driving along the road.
It means
don't overtake on this piece of road.
And what does this sign mean?
The sign means that you must reduce the speed at which you are travelling.
Reduce speed now means slow down.
That means you should slow down.
It means to slow down.
Go slower.
Slow down.
During the lunch break at MAP Advertising, Julia Marsh goes shopping. Excuse me.
Yes, madam.
Could you tell me the way to South Street, please?
Of course. Turn right here. It's the second on the right.
Thank you.
Oh, madam.
Yes?
You can't park here.
But I won't be long. I'll only be a few minutes.
Sorry, madam. You have to move it. You're parked on a yellow line. And there's the sign. Look. You have to use the car park.
10 minutes? I'm in a hurry. I have to go back to work.
Sorry, madam.
Do I have to use the car park?
Yes. This is a no parking area.
Where is the car park?
It's not far. Go along this road and take the second turning on the left. The first is a one-way street. Turn left again and the car park is in front of you.
Thank you.
Now James has a problem with his car.
Good afternoon. Is my car ready?
Mr. Brady?
Yes.
Oh, bad news, I'm afraid.
What is it?
There's something wrong with the brakes. And one of the lights doesn't work.
When can you repair them?
Well, the light is no problem. But the brakes... We can't repair the brakes before next week, I'm afraid. Would you like to rent a car? I'll give you a special price. Just fill in a form and off you go.
Thank you.
Mark Hill is a motorway policeman. He works on the M1, the motorway that goes from London to the north of England. He starts by telling us who can't drive on motorways in Britain.
The people that can't are learner drivers, pedal cyclists, motorcyclists with a certain CC motorcycle, and agricultural vehicles. And also pedestrians are not allowed up on the motorway. On average, we deal with probably 3 to 4 accidents per shift. Bearing in mind, over a 24-hour period, we have 3 shifts. So multiply that by 3 would give us the number of accidents we probably deal with in a day. We have to make sure that persons who are injured are catered for and the extent of their injuries. That is our first step.
Are you all right, my love? You all right? No. Yeah, all right, just hang on there.
The second step is to clear the road as quickly as possible to enable the traffic to flow again. We can try and educate the motorist to drive better. They can look at our driving and perhaps learn from that. But also, when we stop the motorist, advise them where they could better themselves in certain areas.
You're not used to driving on the hard shoulder. Of course, you could hit them. We got a serious accident.
I have a varied working day. I never know what I'm going to deal with from one day to the next. And deal with numerous different people from numerous walks of life. And I don't think there's any other job that can give you that experience.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Today we look at how things work. Let's go to MAP Advertising and meet Carl Schiller. Carl is a client and a friend of Julia Marsh. He's from Munich in Germany. This is his first visit to London.
And I wanted to give you these brochures before tomorrow's meeting. Oh, and I have a present for you.
A present? For me?
Yes.
Carl. Oh.
Do you like it?
Yes, it's great. Thank you very much. Ah. Now, where does this go? Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Here. Oh, and it has a radio, too. How does it work?
There's a switch there.
Yes, it says CD this way and radio that way.
Mm-hmm. And you need these batteries. And this, a CD to help you learn German.
Thanks again, Carl. You're very kind.
You're welcome. Now I must go and find the hotel.
Oh, I can help you there. There's a very nice hotel near where I live, in Wimbledon.
Wimbledon?
Yes, it's about 6 miles, 10 kilometers from the centre of town. But it's a lovely area.
Fine.
Okay. I'll book a room for you and then I'll tell you how to get there.
Thanks.
Mum, food. Come back! Stop! Now listen to me. Never, never, never go near that. Is that clear? Do you understand?
Yes, Mum. What is that?
That's a mouse trap.
What does it do?
It kills mice.
How does it work?
I'll show you. Don't stand there. Move back. Good. Now watch. First, touch the cheese. Next, push down.
Oh.
Then, eat the cheese.
Carl Schiller is at his hotel in Wimbledon. It's the hotel that Julia recommended.
It's cold in here. How do you turn on the heating?
The heating is on, sir. But you're right, it is cold. There's a thermostat here on the wall. I'll turn it up.
Thank you. There's something wrong with the TV. It doesn't work.
You have to press this button.
Uh-huh.
The light switches are here. This turns on your main light, and this turns on the bedside lights. And this is your radio and alarm clock.
Thank you.
Will that be all, sir?
Yes, that's fine. Thanks.
Mildred Cookson is a miller at an old water mill on the River Thames, the mill turns grain into flour for making bread and cakes. But how does the mill work?
The water mill is actually powered by this water wheel here. And that in turn moves all the machinery inside the mill. The grain is brought to the mill in sacks, and I have to get it up from the ground floor up into the roof to store it. Then, when the water wheel starts up, the grain can flow down from where it is on the top floor onto the stone floor where the millstones are, into the millstones. This is a set of millstones without the covering on. The top stone here that goes round, and the bottom stone set in the floor that doesn't move. Here is the shoe, and here is the damsel. The damsel turns with the top stone, and the grain can flow down the shoe, past the damsel, and into the middle of the millstone here. The grain then travels outwards in between the two millstones, being turned slowly into flour as it reaches the edge and gets pushed down a hole in the floor down to the flour bags below.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Today, getting around town.
Julia Marsh's friend, Carl Schiller, is still in London. He's from Munich in Germany. At the weekend, he wants to visit the British Museum, so Julia takes him there. They travel first by bus, then by underground.
Ah, okay. How do we get to the museum?
First we go by bus, and then we go by tube.
Tube? What is that? You buy toothpaste in tubes.
The tube is another word for the underground.
Oh, I see. Tube, like a tunnel, huh?
That's right.
Wow. What's this?
It's your ticket.
Do you have to buy your bus ticket in a shop?
No. This is a special ticket, a one-day ticket. Yeah. You can use it on the buses and on the tube and on the underground.
How much does it cost?
Oh, no more.
Are you sure?
Yes, Carl.
Thanks. Thank you very much. What do I do with this ticket?
What do you mean?
Well, does the driver stamp it? Do I put it into a machine? Or what?
Oh, no. Just show it to the driver when you get on the bus. That's all.
Which station do we go to for the British Museum?
Holborn. We're here, you see, Wimbledon. We take the district line to Notting Hill Gate and then change to the central line. And from Holborn Station, we have to walk.
How far is it from the station to the museum?
Oh, not far. Half a kilometre.
And how long does it take?
From Holborn Station?
No, from here, the whole journey.
About 3/4 of an hour. 50 minutes.
Right, let's go. In Munich, I go everywhere by tram. Are there trams in London?
No. My mother told me there were trams when she was young. But not now.
Why not?
I
I don't know.
How do you get to work? How long does it take?
I have to drive. There's no way that I could take public transport. And it takes me about 45 minutes from home to actually to the office.
By car, it takes about 12 minutes.
I come on the underground.
I drive my truck, my Ford Ranger, and it takes me about 5 minutes to get to school.
I travel to work by overland train and then by tube train, sometimes by bus as well.
I travel to work by canoe. I live on a houseboat which is moored about half a mile away, and I paddle up here in a 16-foot Canadian canoe.
After a long day at the museum, Carl and Julia come back to Wimbledon. They're now waiting for a bus back to Carl's hotel.
And I really like the Egyptian section.
Wasn't it fantastic? And there's so much of it.
How often do these buses run?
Every 10 minutes.
You said that 10 minutes ago. Come on, Julia, let's get a taxi, huh?
Carl, taxis are expensive, and you can still use your one-day ticket.
But it's not far to the hotel. It won't cost much.
All right.
Yeah?
Taxi!
Stop here. How much is that?
$9.99, sir.
Just 10. Keep the change.
Paul Money has a boat, a canal boat. He takes passengers from a part of London called Little Venice to another part of London, Camden Town. Let's join him on the canal as he describes where the boats go.
They go from Little Venice, which is where we are today, down to Hampstead Road Lock, which is in Camden Town. The journey down to Hampstead Road Lock is a distance of about 2.5 miles, so 5 miles in total, and the return journey takes 1.5 hours. There isn't really a typical passenger. Tourists from all countries of the world, groups of old age pensioners who book the boat, and they're our favourite customers for sure. All sorts of people. The journey goes from here through the tunnel under Maeder Hill, which is about 250 metres long. By canal standards, it's quite short. It's one of the shorter tunnels on the system. Some tunnels are as much as 3 miles in length. The fastest that the boat travels is probably about 4.75 miles an hour, although the speed limit is actually 4 miles an hour. The journey makes its way around the northwest edge of Regent's Park, through the London Zoo. There's a beautiful aviary and a few antelope to be seen, and sometimes we get to see the elephant walking around, and then winds down in a very narrow channel past some beautiful old houses and down to Hampstead Road Lock. In the high summer we make 4 trips a day. The return fare for an adult is £4.50, or single fare £3.50. And then there are reductions for children and pensioners. I love boats. The fresh air is a great attraction. If there is a sunny day, I'm out in it. Yes, meeting the people too is very important to me. I couldn't do a job where I didn't have some interaction with people.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Today, we look at cooking and the different ways you can cook.
For example, how do you cook potatoes?
I cook potatoes in a number of different ways. Boiled potatoes are nice, mashed with a little onion and cheese, it's very nice. I don't fry potatoes very often.
My favorite way to cook potatoes is to bake them.
Baked or boiled?
I boil them, but I like sauteed potatoes, so I part-boil them, then fry them.
When I cook them for breakfast, I cut them into thin slices, and I deep fry them.
Julia Marsh is having dinner tonight with James Brady at his flat. James is cooking a traditional Irish meal, Irish stew. James is calling his mother to find out how to make it.
I see. If you use lamb, you cook it for 2 hours. If you use mutton, you cook it for 3 hours. Right? Thanks very much, Mum. Thanks. Bye. First, put in some potatoes. Next, put in the carrots and onions. Then the meat. Now what does she say? After you put in the meat, put in some more potatoes. Oh no! I forgot the parsley. Add some parsley before you serve the meal.
Hello, James.
Hello, Julia. Come in. Oh, thank you.
That smells good. What is it?
Irish stew.
Irish stew? You can cook Irish stew?
Oh, yes.
Today is your birthday, darlings. You are 1 year old today. So we're going to have a birthday meal. Now, what do you want for the first course?
Carrot soup.
And the second course?
Boiled carrots.
And what do you want for the main course?
Baked carrots.
And you'll have a birthday cake, of course.
Millie's is a restaurant in California which serves low-fat, vegetarian food. Its owners are Margaret and Dennis Malone. Here's how Margaret describes their restaurant.
Millie's is a restaurant that is, the emphasis is on heart-healthy, low-fat, gourmet cuisine, and we specialize in providing people with locally grown organic produce.
We mostly steam and blanch and saute and bake. The one thing that we don't do is fry and use oil in deep frying and frying and sauteing. One of the favorite dishes at Millie's that we've been making a lot is a stew. And we do it as a special, and it's called O'Malley's Stew. We get all of the seasonal vegetables that we buy at farmers market, and we wash them and we chop them on our preparation board. Then we get a pot and fill it with water and begin to blanch the carrots and the leeks. After they've been simmering for a couple of minutes, we add the shiitake mushrooms and the smoked tofu. We continue then to add the remaining ingredients. Simmer a while longer. Add some fresh herbs and Let it simmer for a few more minutes, and then the dish is complete.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Your tempeh Normandy. Your shiitake steak, sir. And our special pasta dish.
Thank you. People are more and more interested in not only what they eat, but why they eat. So recently I've started to conduct groups that support people changing their lifestyle and their diet that deal with all the emotional reasons why we choose foods that sometimes are not beneficial.
Look Ahead helps prepare you for Cambridge Level 1, Key English Test, KET. Cambridge Level 2, Preliminary English Test, PET. Contact the British Council or Cambridge Examinations.